Praise the Lord, praise the Lord, praise the Lord. Let everything that have breath praise the Lord. Welcome to 12 Minutes of Meditation by Dr. Cheese. Our focus today is living water can help you worship the Father in spirit and in truth. Living water can help you worship the Father in spirit and in truth. Accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. That God will allow living water to come upon you, to change your life, that you may worship the Father in spirit and in truth. He's looking for you. He seeketh worshippers. Ye korande baba sekirande bobo boshe. Let the living water change your life. Ye korande bobo boshe la 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 la. The living water can help you worship the Father in spirit and in truth. Ye koratara la 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 ba sekirande bobo boshe la 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 la. He'll remove all the hurts of the past. Ye ka tarande bo 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 shala la la la. He will bring you into a sure place in him. Ye ko rande bo 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 shala la 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 la. Why don't you yield your members to the Spirit of God? Ye ko rande ba 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 siki ando bo bo. Why don't you allow God to guide you by his Spirit? That you may worship him in spirit and in truth. When the living water comes, he's the Spirit of truth. This living water, he won't speak of himself. Whatever he hear the Father saying, he will speak to you. Come on, get this living water. Ye ko rande bo 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 shia la 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 la. Ye ko rande bo 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 shiki ande basi. I thank God today for living water, the living water that comes from the Father. It's a promise from the Father. Ye ko ra ta ra ra la basi. I thank God for this living water that would change my life, remove all my hurts, remove all my prejudice from my heart. It's the living water. When the woman was at the well, Jesus confronted the woman, told the woman, go get your husband, because this woman, she realized that she needed this living water. She had been married 5 times, and the one she was with was not her own husband. And Jesus told her, go get your husband. And the woman, she was telling the truth. She said, I don't have a husband. Jesus said, you have said correctly. But once this woman perceived that Jesus was a prophet, she began to tap into the problems that was going on in her heart. One of the problems that were going on in her heart is about worship. And I'm telling you today, living water can help you worship the Father in spirit and in truth. Jesus told the woman, that woman, believe believe me that the hour has come that when ye shall neither in this mountain nor yet at Jerusalem worship the Father. So there's no sacred place. There's no secret or sacred place to worship God. And we have made places now. There's no sacred place required to worship God. Because this woman says, okay, our fathers, they worship in the mountains. But you say, because she know he was a Jew, you say that in Jerusalem is the place where they ought to worship. So Jesus was giving this woman some spiritual insight that there's coming to a time that there's no sacred place that is required to worship the Father. And matter of fact, he said, ye worship, ye know not. So there's many that are out there worshiping the Father, but they don't know the Father. And even we see that in Samuel chapter 3, where God began to call Samuel, that you can see Samuel putting on the ephod and worship and ministering before the Lord. You can see him ministering before the Lord on three occasions that is listed in the Bible. So you can imagine that the Bible, it can't write everything down. So you would assume that he had worshiped the Lord in many occasions. But then the Bible says in Samuel chapter 3, Samuel did not yet know the Lord, nor the word of the Lord was revealed unto him yet. So you can be worshiping, but not worshiping the true God. You're not worshiping in the spirit and in truth until God showed up. God began to reveal to him himself. Perhaps he picked up all the patterns of Eli. Do it this way, do it that way. But he did not yet know the Lord. So you could be worshiping something that you do not know of. Even, let's look at Acts chapter 17. Acts chapter 17. Wow. Acts chapter 17. You see that when Paul went to Mars Hill and he told the men of Athens, I perceive that you are very superstitious. And then Paul went on to say, I saw a sign, an altar with this description, to the unknown God. So they were worshiping, they were believing in this unknown God. So people can be worshiping in the church every Sunday, but do not know God. And the men of Mars, they were worshiping this unknown God. And Paul was trying to bring clarity as an apostle. He said, whom therefore ye ignorantly worship. So they worship this unknown God. Well, we heard about him, but we don't know him. And Paul said, God has made the world and all things therein, seeing that he is Lord of heaven and earth. He don't dwell in the temples made with hands. So people can go forth and worship things or worship him, the Father, and don't know him. And then this is what's in the past. Also in the past, the Jews know who they worship. The Jews, they knew who to worship. They were given, matter of fact, when they came out of Egypt, one of the things that he told Pharaoh, that let my people go, that they may come and worship me. And so the Jews, they knew who they were worshiping. Praise the Lord. And so he was the, matter of fact, even when Jesus went to the cross, they put on the cross, the King of the Jews. And so this was in the past, how even the Bible says the salvation is for the Jews. This was in the past. Let's look at this in Matthew chapter 10. Matthew chapter 10. Now, this was in Jesus' time, right? Matthew chapter 10, when he commissioned the disciples to go forth and preach. And then he said in verse 5, when he commanded them to go and preach, he said, go not unto the way of the Gentiles and into any city of the Samaritans. Enter ye not. So the disciples were commanded not to even minister or don't go unto the Gentiles, because salvation is for the Jews. Are y'all hearing me? I say, what are you doing, Cheeseburger? Well, again, this was in the past. They didn't know not what they were worshiping. Just like the woman who was at the well. The woman at the well, she didn't know what she was worshiping. And the people that was connected with her, they didn't know. But in the past, the Jews knew who they were worshiping. And Jesus told his disciples, don't go to the Gentiles to preach the gospel. Don't go to the Samaritans to preach the gospel. Matter of fact, let's look at in Matthew chapter 15, we see the woman of Canaan, the Greek woman, her daughter was vexed with the spirit. In Matthew chapter 15, you see that she pursued Jesus, and matter of fact, she worshiped him, saying, Lord, help me, because her daughter was vexed with the spirit. And this woman had so much pain because of her daughter, and she was going forth after Jesus, and Jesus answered her and said, it is not meet to take the children's bread, because you're not part of this program right now, and cast it to the dogs. But this woman, she knew something about being a maid. She said, truly, Lord, yet the dogs eat the crumbs which falls from the master's tables. And Jesus came forth and said, woman, great is thy faith, be it unto thee even as thou wilt. So I say to you today that salvation is for the Jews in Jesus' time. But then when Jesus tell the woman that the hour has come now, this is the woman at the well. He's telling her, hey, now there's a universal worship. It's not just for the Jews. When I met you at this well, I'm opening the door for not just the Jews. I'm opening up the doors for the Gentiles. I'm opening up the doors for the Samaritans. I'm opening up the doors for universal worship. And so we see this woman, she received that word. And you see the woman at the well, because when Jesus was at the cross, he also opened it up even more for the universal worship. Because you begin to see how God began to use Peter to go and minister to the Gentiles at Cornelius' house, and how the Spirit of the Lord fell upon Cornelius' family like they did in the day of Pentecost. And then as I mentioned that Jesus revealed to the woman that there's no sacred places. There's no sacred places that are required to worship the Father. So why people are putting so much emphasis on Jerusalem? I got to go to Jerusalem. I got to go to the Jerusalem. Well, let Jerusalem come into your mind. Let the new Jerusalem come forth from heaven. So Jesus told the woman, hey, it's coming a time, and the time is now, that I'm bringing forth a universal worship, meaning everybody can come now, not just the Jews. I'm opening up for everyone to come. And then we find in verse 20, when the woman said, our father worship in the mountain, and ye say that in Jerusalem is the place where men ought to worship. Listen, the Jews were saying, hey, all the Jews, you come to Jerusalem and worship the Father. You come in your feast, you come in your time of season, you come and worship the Father. Now, Jesus is giving us some spiritual insight here. He said, in the days to come, and the time is now, I tell you. It says, woman, believe me, the hour is coming where ye shall neither in this mountain nor yet at Jerusalem. I don't think we read this before. He said, look here, don't forget about the mountains, forget about Jerusalem, about worshiping the Father. When you talk about worship, you're going to have to worship the Father in spirit and in truth. That means you can worship the Father everywhere you go and anywhere where you are located. If you're driving, you can worship him there, as long as you're doing it in spirit and in truth. You can worship him wherever you go. And then the Father, he's seeking for true worshipers to worship him. Matter of fact, he'll look for you like he found Samuel, like he found Moses, that he found David. He'll go after those that are seeking him. Even he went after Paul. Hallelujah. Saul, his name was converted later to Paul. That he went after him because the Father, he seek true worshipers to worship him. Well, here's the pattern. God is a spirit. And when he ministered to you, he gonna minister to your spirit. He gonna touch your spirit. And when your spirit come in contact with God's spirit, join with God's spirit, what's in your spirit is going to come to your mind. You're going to get words in your mind. You're going to get a picture in your mind. It has come from your spirit that rise up to your mind, and you begin to put words to what you see. You begin to put words on what you hear, and then you begin to worship the Father in spirit and in truth. So whatever comes into your spirit that is from the Father, it's the truth. And you can worship him in spirit and in truth. Even you can worship him for, he'll give you the right words for that moment. He'll give you the right words on what to call him in that moment, because what comes into your spirit is going to rise up into your mind. That's why you have a helper. The living water will help you worship the Father, because he's going to touch your spirit, and whatever in your spirit is going to rise up to your mind, and then now you can worship him in spirit because you're receiving this in the spirit and you'll worship him in the spirit. He may tell you, get on your knees. And then now you'll worship him according to his guidance. He's guiding you. So those living waters will help you worship the Father in spirit and in truth. Thank you for listening to 12 Minutes of Meditation by Dr. Cheese.